This image is beautiful, highly detailed, and slightly bizarre. It is either the world's smallest painting of a giraffe or the world's largest matchstick. Either way, I've got to know how they did this. Okay, so it's obviously a miniature giraffe, and the person who painted it is this woman, Lorraine Lutz. She's an artist based in Cape Town, South Africa, and a bit of an Instagram celebrity. But unlike most artists who paint on a large canvas or a handheld sketch pad, Lorraine creates art smaller than most coins.
I do semi-photorealistic watercolor miniature paintings. I've painted on and off throughout my life, but I only really started taking it seriously about 3 years ago.
In 2013, Lorraine began a project called Paintings for Ants, a collection of 365 mini photorealistic drawings of ordinary objects or animals, one sketch for every day of the year.
I came up with the idea for Paintings for Ants when I was doing a business course for artists. I had decided not to become an artist after all, and knew that with my day job I wouldn't make time to paint. So I constructed this borderline OCD plan to complete one artwork every day for an entire year. The only thing I could finish in the time I could save, which was about an hour, would be a miniature painting. And so 365 paintings for ants was born.
And Lorraine's work paid off. Her tiny masterpieces soon went viral, and today she has over 200,000 admirers across social media.
My typical workflow is quite simple. I find something to listen to, like a podcast. I get all my tools together and I start painting, and I don't stop until I'm finished. My eyes are super sensitive, but strangely so are my ears. So much so that I don't go anywhere without my custom-made earplugs and noise-cancelling headphones. I use a grey watercolour pencil to sketch the outlines of the image, and then I use watercolour paint to complete the image. My favourite things to paint are galaxies, animals, and food, I would say, and that would explain this year's project. At first, finishing a painting would take me between an hour or 2 hours, but as I started getting more into it and after it became my permanent job, I could spend up to 8 hours finishing one piece. I don't find it difficult at all painting so small. It's something that I've always been practicing in some way or another, and I just feel like it's what comes most naturally to me. Art is everything to me. It's my livelihood, it's my passion, it's my meditation, it's everything.
Hey guys, if you like this video, check out this one on Seeker Stories about Linkin Park band member Mike Shinoda and his street artwork.
Whether it's music or drawing, painting, anything like that, art for me, it's like breathing in the sense that I don't think about it. I just do it.
And as always, thanks for watching.